Hey Stallions!
Welcome back to this episode of
SFDTV.
Today we'll be talking about Women's History Month.
Then we're going to be covering how this Women's History Month came about,
narrated by our very own Mrs. Paula Menny.
Then we're going to be covering women at DeSales in STEM.
And interviewing some of our own women here at DeSales.
Then we're going to be showing some hype clips from our individual athletes.
And that'll be all followed up by an interview with Devin Kerwin and our Stallions for Social Justice Club.
Take it away, Mrs. Paula Menny.
Women's History Month provides an opportunity for people to reflect on the time, effort, and passion women have historically contributed to advance opportunities for all people. Originating in 1981 as Women's History Week, women's history has grown in celebration. The month of March allows individuals to recognize the important contributions women have made to society. Women like Rosalind Franklin, Sonia Sotomayor, Ella Fitzgerald, and Malala Yousafzai. However, our recognition of amazing women should not be limited to those in history books or on our screens. Women within our own communities can be looked at as inspiration and deserve to be celebrated as well.
One word to describe what a strong woman is.
Confident.
Fearlessness.
Kind.
Self-sufficient.
Assertive.
Compassionate.
One of my greatest role models is my mother. Growing up, she would always teach me that the answer is no until you ask. So when that came to talking to adults or getting what I wanted, I was always taught the answer's no until you ask. So ask.
I would say my sister, because she's just been a big role model to me ever since we were little, since she's 4 years older than me. So I've always looked up to her, and she just pushes me to be the best me that I can be.
My mom, she's always been a strong, independent woman in my life. Growing up with a single mother, I always looked up to her and her strength and her fearlessness, and it always inspired me to be fearless.
I would say my friends, because we celebrate each other's accomplishments no matter how big or small, and they never fail to redirect me on my path towards my goals when I need them.
Greatest female role model in my life, honestly, has been my mother. She is an angel on earth and goes above and beyond to help anyone that she comes in touch with.
For me, I would have to say my grandma, because she was a really strong farmhand. She really valued education and kindness. And she inspired me to pursue a career teaching.
Now we have Mrs. Garrick and Mrs. Scott to tell us a little bit about women in STEM.
Hello everyone, Mrs. Garrick here, and I'm talking about women in STEM. Now I chose to be a math major because I really enjoy math. To me it's like a puzzle, it's a game, and I love spreading that joy to my students. About a third of the women who work for Amazon, Apple, Facebook, Google, and Microsoft, only 34%, or one-third, are women. Although you had about 50% of the women who have a STEM-related bachelor degree. So come on, women. The other thing that I found interesting in my long thing of statistics is that 74% of the girls said they wanted to get into a STEM career. So that was very exciting. Now, let's look at some of our pioneers. Katherine Johnson, who worked for NASA. If you've seen the movie Hidden Figures, like I have about 50 times, she has an amazing life. But the other thing, if you notice, she broke gender barriers and color barriers. So I find her amazing. So she started in the 50s. She worked for doing the calculations for the spacecraft in orbit. But the thing I really liked is that John Glenn said he wouldn't actually proceed until Katherine Johnson, by hand, did the math calculations before he actually went ahead and got on there and to orbit the Earth. And also, in 2015, she was awarded the U.S. Presidential Medal of Freedom. So we have a lot of people behind us to support women in STEM. And so please continue doing that and enjoy what a great career this is.
So why did I want to be in the field of STEM? As a little girl, I just absolutely loved science. I was really interested in space, and I wanted to go to the moon and all those sorts of things. I loved my Barbies as much as I did the tools, because I had tool time every Saturday with my dad. And so what inspired me to go into teaching in science was actually because of my love of science. And where I was raised, I wasn't able to just graduate from high school and go right on into college. So I had a career first, but I always still wanted to be a science teacher and in like physics, chemistry, more the math type sciences. The day the Challenger exploded in 1986, and there was a teacher in space, and she was going to do science experiments. That was the day that I made my decision. I went in the next day, quit my job, and decided this is my passion, this is what I'm pursuing, and I was 28 at the time. Couple of people who really inspired me in STEM. When I was at Ohio State, I had, as a chemistry professor, the first female chemist at the Ohio State University. She was tough, really tough, but her stamina and her willingness to say, I am a woman, I am smart, I can do this, inspired me to do the same thing, to just say, I can do this.
Okay. Thank you to the beautiful women of the cells for sharing their inspiring words and their role models.
Hey.
Yeah.
Hey. All right, y'all, now let's get ready for our 2022 female commits.
Period. It is.
Amazing. Hey Jocelyn, you want to go listen to Deborah from the Stallions of Social Justice Club?
Yep, let's go.
So I started the Stallions for Social Justice Club as a way for students to come together and not only talk about things that they cared about, but also do things about the things that they cared about. So like earlier in the year, we raised money for refugees from Afghanistan. We raised money for children at the border who've gotten detained. And from those two projects, we raised about $600. We are currently working on fundraising for the Malala Fund, which is a organization run by Malala Yousafzai. It works to help women and girls in countries where they don't really have the opportunity to go to secondary school to be able to go there. And so it's a really cool organization because it's something that we here in the United States don't really have, we have the luxury not to have to deal with it. But a lot of women around the world do. So for Women's History Month, we decided to choose that organization to fundraise for.
Thank you for watching. And happy Women's History Month!
Woo!
My! I hate that.
I don't get what the joke is,
okay,
bro.
Okay, ready?